Good morning student, welcome back once again to the fifth part of this video. Now we will be discussing about deficiency disease. Now our body, as we know, our body requires a balanced diet to stay healthy. Now if you take excess of any particular nutrient, if there is excess particular nutrient in our body, then it can cause toxicity. So malnutrition, what is this malnutrition? It is the condition that develop when the body does not get right amount of nutrient. Means this malnutrition means our body does not get right amount of nutrition in the diet. That is malnutrition. Undernutrition, what is this? When the food intake is less, the amount of food that is required by our body is less than what it is needed. That is undernutrition. Now deficiency disease. This deficiency disease caused by the lack of carbohydrate, protein, fats, vitamin and mineral in a person's diet are called deficiency disease. When this balanced diet is not present in the diet, then it causes deficiency disease. Deficiency disease can occur due to wrong food habits. Means if you are having wrong fooding habit, deficiency disease may occur. Now see, deficiency of carbohydrate. We get, as we know, that carbohydrate provides us energy. Now if there is a lack of carbohydrate in the food for a very long time, then it can lead to weakness and lack of stamina. Second thing, weight loss. Now people, those who do more physical work, they require more carbohydrate because they have to get extra energy. Now excess of carbohydrate and fat increase in the body leads to obesity, means fattiness. The weight of an obese person is more than his or her healthy weight, means the weight increases. Deficiency of proteins and fat. Proteins are essential for muscle development and promote growth. The lack of protein in the diet for a long time can cause improper body growth, mental weakness, skin diseases, discoloration of hair. Hair color will discolor, black will turn into brownish or something. Now fats, these are required in very less quantities. However, fat dissolve certain vitamins like A, D, E, K. These are the fat soluble vitamins. The lack of sufficient fat in the diet may cause poor absorption of fat-soluble vitamin, which can cause deficiency disease. Now, if there is a lack of fat in our body, then there will be a poor absorption of fat-soluble vitamins, which cause deficiency disease. Two main deficiency diseases are quassicor and marasmus. Quassicor, this condition occurs due to severe protein deficiency. Quassicor is a disease that occurs when there is a lack of protein, too much lack of protein in the body. The disease mainly occurs in children below 5 years of age. Now this disease occurs only below the This disease occur only in children that is below the age of 5 years. The child that suffer from quassicor have the following symptoms. What are the symptoms? Dark and scaly skin, protruding belly, swollen legs due to accumulation of water, loss of appetite, mental weakness. These are the symptoms that occurs in a baby or in a child. They are suffering from quassicor. Quassicor disease can be cured by giving protein rich diet to the children. Now if the children is given protein rich diet, then this disease can be cured. Marasmus, it is a disease caused by severe deficiency of carbohydrate. Now marasmus, how it is caused? If the child is suffering from deficiency of carbohydrate, then the child will suffer from marasmus. Not only carbohydrate, protein and fats, these are the three things: protein, carbohydrates and fat. If the child is suffering from marasmus, that means the child is lacking carbohydrate, protein and fats. It affects children below 5 years of age, like Kwashiorkor. Those child who are suffering from marasmus have the following symptoms: lean and thin body with sunken eyes, the eyes are seen backward, weak muscles, poor mental growth. These are the symptoms of a baby having or child having marasmus. Now complete diet should be given to a child suffering from marasmus. Now if the child is given complete diet, then this deficiency disease will disappear. Now deficiency of vitamins and deficiency of mineral. These two vitamins and minerals deficiency is given in the table I'll be showing you. So here table 2.2, this is vitamin deficiency. Now this table 2.2, it shows you the deficiency of disease of vitamins A, B1, B2, B6, C, D, K. These are the sources from where we are getting. These are the function. What are the function of these vitamins? And deficiency disease. What are the disease that is caused by this vitamin deficiency disease? Now, table 2.3, it shows the deficiency of minerals. These are calcium, phosphorus, iron, iodine, fluorine, sodium, potassium. Sources from where we will be getting, what are the function of these vitamins, what are the deficiency disease and symptoms of this disease. And the last part of the chapter is midday meal scheme. This midday meal scheme is a program launched by the government of India. It aims to provide free nutrition to children primary classes. It solves two purposes: prevent malnutrition among the child and improves attendance in school. Two things are done for this midday meal. First, to prevent children from suffering from malnutrition, and to increase the attendance in school. This plan has been adopted by most Indian states after a landmark direction. The Supreme Court has gave order to provide this midday meal scheme. According to the government, accordingly to the Supreme Court's rule, the government provide the government provide cooked meals to all children in all government primary schools.